CS is, I think, probably the most booming market currently. You see, like, the best jobs in this department right now. So you have.
So to give us some light on CSA department, we have Ananya with us. Hi, Ananya. Can you introduce yourself?
So my name is Ananya. I'm a final year undergraduate and now graduated from IIT Guwahati. I completed my bachelor's in technology in computer science and engineering from here.
Alright. So what is like daily life of a CSC student over here?
So like CSC is comparatively a bit heavy branch on like as compared to other courses that we have in our college. So it basically consists of two parts. One is your practical and second is the theoretical. Practical labs have a lot of importance in our like in our course structure, and they carry a lot of weightage also. Plus, like you do most of your practical learning, which is quite important in computer science and engineering in your practical courses. So you spend a lot of your time in these labs, and like in IIT Guwahati, you have a personal system with you, and you spend a lot of your nights there. Coding your assignments.
All right. Can you give us some light on what do you majorly study throughout this 4 years?
So in computer science, like you first start with your basic computer science fundamentals, like learning a programming language like C++, which is introduced in your first year. Then after that, you go on to learn the basics of computer science that are very essential. So you learn about data structures and algorithms. You learn about operating systems, compilers, databases, and all those core CS courses like networks. So after that, then you go to your like electives, like which you can choose upon your choice, like artificial intelligence and courses related to that. And so these courses come in your like third and fourth year. So these are generally elective in nature.
All right. So talking about ease or toughness of your course, what do you think?
So I think comparatively it's a bit on the tougher side, like as compared to other departments. So the course structure is a bit heavy. Plus the competition is comparatively a bit more than other branches. That's what I feel like after studying for like 4 years in this department.
Okay. And what about credits, electives and CGP?
So on the elective sides, you have different courses related to artificial intelligence and machine learning. You also have courses related to computer graphics, parallel algorithms, like computer architecture, like advanced computer architecture in our college. On the CGPA side, like I think that like you should try to maintain a CGPA of at least 7.5 if you are in computer science department. And like for the credits, like it's same for the first year for everyone in our college. And after that, branching happens. And after that, you get into a department, and then you have to compete with the people in your department.
Alright. Talking about theoretical versus practical knowledge.
As for the practical part of the course, like you have a lot of labs in computer science and engineering, and that they are quite important in terms of because that is something that you actually apply in the real world. So there are sufficient number of labs and lab-based assignments in computer science department.
Right. Can you give us some light on job prospectus, like what type of job, what kind, what field?
So like CS is, I think, probably the most booming market currently. You see like the best jobs in this department right now. So you have jobs related to software development, you have jobs related to data science and machine learning. So these are the two like main important parts in which the jobs are divided.
All right. Can you name some company which come to hire students?
So there are many companies that come to our campus, like Microsoft, Google, Goldman, Amazon, Flipkart, like most of your major firms come to visit the campus.
What were your thoughts about this branch and what it turned out to be? Was it all same or something?
Yeah, so on this part, like I expected, like when I joined engineering, I was not a mechanical kind of person. So I was never inclined toward those branches. Plus I always liked solving problems. So if you like problem solving, you like logical thinking, solving puzzles, I think computer science is the branch for you.
Alright, now very asked question, like what is the best salary or average salary of a CSE?
So like I think CSE has probably the best placement statistics in our college. So the average salary is around, I think the CTC average is 23 or 22 in our college. And the highest domestic package ranges at around 60 LPA. And like this year due to COVID, they were not meant, like I don't think so, they were international recruitment. But usually Microsoft Redmond comes to our college and they offer a salary package of around 1.5.
Alright. And talking about a higher study opportunity for in colleges.
Yeah, so CSE has a lot of opportunities, like you can apply globally for your master's, and many people pursue master's after their four years, and it's a very popular field. So yeah, there is a lot of opportunities because CSE is currently moving across the world, and like AI, machine learning, they are very important technologies right now. So there is a lot of scope for this.
Is there anything you wish you knew when you were in your first year?
So I think like the most important thing that I wish I knew was like probably opening up more to people and going with the flow. That is something I think is very important. So people start like thinking a lot about their future. So instead of that, like going with the flow, taking things one at a time and solving them, having a mentality of solving problems and taking them one at a time, I think serves like will save you a lot of mental energy. Plus, I think personally, on my personal front, like opening up a lot, like opening up more to people, is something I think I should have done. So yeah. Thanks.
All right. Any suggestion for your upcoming juniors?
For my upcoming juniors is like enjoy your time in campus, like study hard, like and do like whatever you want to do. So if you are like, try to maintain your academics, like try at least maintaining a CGPA of 7.5 if you are interested in joining computer science. Don't throw away your academics also. Plus, after academics, have some hobby that will help you in relieve your stress and yeah, so that.
Thank you.